William Owsley, an English diplomat who visited Julfa in 1812, writes, "We saw the remnants of Julfa, now an annihilated city, lying amidst beautiful rocks and mountains. It is situated on a bank of the Arax, with the remains of a castle and a small tower nearby. I studied the main ruins of Julfa carefully. In the vicinity of an ancient church, a fine tombstone, engraved with some reliefs and an Armenian epitaph, was preserved. From a nearby elevation, I took a photograph of what was once a bridge extending over the river Arax below the city." Madame Chantre, a French investigator who visited the ruins of Julfa in 1890, writes, "All the local remarkable buildings have fallen prey to fire and have been demolished. It is difficult at present to form a mental picture of the original city." In 1894, the world-famous encyclopedia of Brockhaus Yeffron wrote that the only remnants of the city, which once claimed 50,000 inhabitants, now comprised ruins of houses and churches, as well as a large cemetery and the foundations of some two or three bridges lying over the river Arax. Julfa used to boast 9 churches and monasteries, which were as follows: St. Ovanes, St. Gevorg, St. Minas, St. Hagop, St. Andriordi, Surp Asvazadzin, Holy Virgin, Surp Amenapergich, Holy Savior, Surp Yerortutyun, Holy Trinity, Orverin Upper Katan, and Pomblos Jam, Pomblos Church. Although Shah Abbas deported Julfa Armenians and devastated the city, he did not touch the local cemetery extending over 3 hills on the bank of the Arax River in the southwest of the city. The ancient cemetery was a unique specimen of Armenian cultural heritage, which occupied a special place in the treasury of world civilization. French researcher Alexandre de Rhodes, who visited the site of the city 43 years after its fall in 1648, saw 10,000 standing, ornate khachkars, cross stones there. By the early 20th century, their number had dropped to about 6,000 only, including some ram-shaped tombstones. The cemetery also retained 2 churches and a chapel. As William Owsley writes, "That large cemetery, comprising rows of a huge number of standing gravestones that resemble densely arrayed soldiers from afar, is living proof of the number of people the city formerly enjoyed. They perpetuate the memory of many generations, constituting the overall result of many centuries of creative work." Robert Kerr Porter, an English artist and archaeologist who visited Julfa in 1819, describes the cemetery in the following manner: 3 hills densely covered with graves lying within a foot of each other, long vertical stones, some of them between 8 and 10 feet high. You can hardly find a single one that is not skillfully engraved with various reliefs representing crosses, saints, angels, birds, animals, etc. It would not be an exaggeration to say that this cemetery of the ancient Armenian people contains thousands of outstanding gravestones. In the same year, Mesrop Taryadyans wrote, "The deceased inhabitants of Julfa tell you even more about their ancestors' glory than those alive. The reliefs and motifs of their gravestones, as well as their numerous splendid epitaphs, are well worth of being recorded in the history of art." World-famous artist Mardiros Sarian, who visited the cemetery in 1914, writes, I was amazed at the unsurpassed artistic value of the Khachkars, as well as the wonderful variety marking their reliefs. In the meantime, however, I was shocked to see that some of them had been broken during the construction of the railway. In September 1915, Scottish linguist and archaeologist Nicholas Marr gave an assignment to photographer Aram Varuir to work in the cemetery. In 1928, Lithuanian art historian Jurgis Baltrušaitis conducted research there. The tombstones of Julfa Cemetery fall into three groups. The first group includes the period between the 9th and 13th centuries. The second one, the 14th and 15th centuries. And the third embraces the time span between the early 16th century and the year 1605. All the Khachkars are carved of pink and yellowish stone. Having equal width from top to bottom, they are between 2 and 2.5 meters high. Their central parts are more deeply cut. The crosses and two-layer reliefs creating a peculiar contrast between light and shade. The cornices of the Khachkars often bear the representation of Christ, the Evangelists, and Holy Virgin. Below the cross, a finely carved rosette and the branches of a tree of life can be seen, while the lower part of the stone is engraved with an epitaph and a relief representing the deceased person. The cemetery was an eloquent witness to Julfa Armenia's glorious past. In the Soviet years, the cemetery became part of the territory of Nakhichevan, which had been annexed to the Republic of Azerbaijan. The Monuments Preservation Department of that country absolutely neglected it. Moreover, under state auspices, its tombstones were continuously broken to pieces and used as construction material. The investigation Agram Ayvazyan conducted in the cemetery in 1971 and 1973 showed that it retained over 3,000 Khachkars. Almost the same number was documented in 1987 when Dr. Murad Hasratyan and art historian Zaven Sarkisyan visited Julfa. In 1998, Nakhichevan's Azeri authorities started destroying the cemetery of Julfa with bulldozers to get rid of the countless Armenian monuments that attested to the Armenian identity of the territory and exposed the historical reality. Even UNESCO proved unable to prevent the annihilation of that part of Armenian cultural heritage. The photographs taken in autumn of 2002 revealed that the famous cemetery of Julfa did not have a single standing Khachkar anymore. Having never been held accountable for these atrocities, the Azeri vandals resumed the destruction of the cemetery between the 10th and 14th of December 2005. With the complicity of their army, more than 100 soldiers, armed with heavy hammers and pickaxes, reduced the Khachkars to a heap of crumbled pieces. The fragments were loaded onto lorries with excavators and thrown in the Arak's facing side of the railway. Thus, in December 2005, the Azeri authorities finally attained the goal they had been pursuing for many years, the purging of the three hills of the Khachkars.